Hello student, so first of all let me introduce the quantum statistics. So this is my second lecture, and basically see that in the previous lecture we have done the Boltzmann statistics, and we have known every bit of that. Now we are coming to the Bose-Einstein statistics. So basically what is the Bose-Einstein statistics? It is the indistinguishable identical particle of zero or an integral spin, and it has an overlapping of psi and bosons, but they do not obey the exclusion principle. And the Fermi-Dirac statistics is that indistinguishable identical particle of odd half integral spin, half 3 by 2, 5 by 2, and it has an overlapping of psi and the fermions, that they do not obey the exclusion principle. So what is the difference between the Bose-Einstein statistics and Fermi-Dirac statistics? Firstly, they have an integral spin or zero, whereas in the Fermi-Dirac statistics it has half, it has 3 by 2 and 5 by 2, which means that it has odd half integral spin. They have a both similarity that psi has overlapped, that is a wave function. And the example of the Bose-Einstein is bosons, and example of Fermi-Dirac is fermions. And the quite most difference is that in the quantum mechanics, in the quantum statistics, Bose-Einstein they do not obey the exclusion principle, whereas the fermions obeys the exclusion principle. Okay, they do not obey, and whereas they obey the exclusion principle. This is the most important similarities as well as the difference that can come into exam. Now the wave function of a system of the bosons is not affected by the exchange of the pair of electron. So basically when there is any exchange of the electron take place, okay, there is no change in the wave function. Whereas in the case of fermions, the exchange of the pair of electron changes the sign of a fermions. So when there is any change of electron, it can replace the sign either to plus or to minus. Now see, that's why the bosons, due to the unexchange of the ion, the bosons is called symmetric, and due to the exchange of the ion, the fermions is called anti-symmetric. You can see it, the bosons is called the symmetric, whereas the fermions is known as the anti-symmetric. And there is another difference: any number of the boson can exist in the same quantum state of the system, and only the one fermion can exist in only one quantum state of a system. So this is just quite a difference. So what are the difference? First one is they are not affected by the exchange of pair of electron, whereas they are affected by the exchange of pair of electron, and it is symmetric, while it is anti-symmetric. And any number of bosons can exist in the same quantum state, and this is only one fermion can exist in the one quantum state of a system. So these are the difference. And now going to next slide. Now see, basically consider a system of particle. Suppose name as the particle as particle 1 and particle 2, and they are in the state A and they are in the state B. So if we consider that particle A and B, the state are A and B, and the particle name is 1 and 2, so and we assume that the particle are distinguishable, okay, so there are possible of the occupancy of the state is psi 1 equal to psi 1 A of 1 into psi B of 2, and psi of 2 equal to psi A of 2 and psi B of 1. If the particle is distinguishable, we can write this as this. As there is two wave functions, we can
interchange their state, and if there is not distinguishable, if the particle is not distinguishable and there is two wave functions, we can write the bosons as 1 by root over of 2 bracket psi a of 1 psi a of 2 plus psi a of 2 psi b of 1, and in the fermions the same result, but a minus sign is indicated, but a minus sign is indicated. And why this plus sign, why this minus sign? Because I have just told that the wave function is affected, not affected in the case of bosons, but the wave function is affected in the case of fermions. That's why they are called the symmetric wave functions and they are called the anti-symmetric wave functions. In earlier case we have considered the two state, so if we consider each to be a one state, so both are, see here in the previous case here it is written A and here it is written B, but as it is the same state, so both are A and we can consider only one wave function. If there is two states, we can consider two, but if there is one state, we can, it can be done in one unit. Now probability density, what is the probability density? If we have gone from my quantum mechanics lecture, the probability density is given by this one. The probability density is given by this one. So basically, see, the probability density, this is the form, only just one star is denoted at the top, all are the same. Okay, if I write this term as bosons and fermions, if I want to write this term as bosons, in the case of bosons and in the case of the fermions, see, this is the formula of bosons, and if these two functions are equal, if these two functions are equal, okay, so considering that they are both at the same state, so these two functions are equal, we can write this term. And if this function are equal, then the fermions is zero, because this is minus and it is affected by the wave function, so it becomes zero. So it can be said that two fermions cannot exist in a same state. Two fermions cannot exist in the same state, because in the same state they are becoming zero, which may, it is not possible to become the number of fermions to be zero. So we can say the two fermions cannot exist in the same state. Now Bose-Einstein statistics and Fermi-Dirac distribution function. So the probability Fe that the bosons occupy a state of energy E turns out to be that 1 by e to the power alpha e to the power e by kt minus 1, and in the case of fermion, 1 by e to the power alpha e to the power e by kt plus 1, and it is, you have to remember. And what is the Fe? Fe is the probability that the bosons occupy, bosons or a fermion, this can be two, occupy a state of energy E, a state of energy, this have a state of energy E, and turns out to be this formula. And see that if I consider the E is greater than kT, so actually this term is neglected. And if this term is neglected, see that these two equations approaches towards the Maxwell-Boltzmann equation, and this e to the power alpha, okay, where the alpha term depends on the properties of a particular system and is also a function of T, it is a temperature. How is the properties and what is the temperature? These two, it is very much dependent. Now note this graph very carefully. See, the alpha first is it is the Bose-Einstein. What is the Bose-Einstein? Bose-Einstein is integral spin of zero and integral spin or zero. So basically that's why it is in this side, and the Bose-Einstein. And if I see the previous slide, see, in the Bose-Einstein it is minus one, and 1 divided by e to the power alpha e to the power e by kt minus 1 is always gives a greater value than the Fermi Dirac statistic because this is plus 1. So see it that as it gives a greater value, so Bose-Einstein is in this side and the Fermi Dirac is in this side, and the Maxwell Boltzmann is in this side because the e will be much much greater than kt. So for that condition, if I put the value of both and apply such condition, so the Maxwell-Boltzmann graph will be looking like this. And we have just said that the alpha is depend upon the how is the properties of the particular medium, and it is a normally a function of the t. Okay, so how can we find the value? The quantum mechanics has a concept of the normalization condition, so by which we can find the values. Now minus 1 term in the denominator of the Boltzmann distribution, the minus 1, if I note the equation again, it is 1 by in the Bose-Einstein, it is 1 by e to the power alpha e to the power e by kt minus 1. So that minus 1 in the denominator of the Boltzmann distribution expresses the multiple occupancy, expresses the multiple occupancy of the energy state by the bosons, while the plus 1 indicates the uncertainty principle. Okay, now if I look at the equation again, that this alpha, this e energy value and this temperature, okay, and if I put the value, we can see that the Fe value cannot exist 1 because it is 1 by e to the power alpha e to the power e by kt minus 1 or plus 1, although it cannot exist the 1, the value 1, okay, it should be stay within 1. Now come on to the Fermi Dirac distribution function. So what is a Fermi Dirac distribution function? Now only we have studied Fermi Dirac distribution function is Fd of E equals to 1 by alpha E by K by E to the power E by KT plus 1. This is the Fermi Dirac formula. And F of D, E equal to half for an energy, EF equal to minus alpha kt. Okay, so when the Fermi Dirac function, when the probability of the Fermi Dirac function is half for an energy of EF, half kt, so this is called the Fermi energy. Okay, and it is a very important quantity in the system of fermions, such as electron gas in a metal. In the term of EF, the Fermi Dirac function can be written as this. So I mean to say that we know this formula, and when Fd equal to half for an energy like this, so what is actually the Fermi energy? Fermi energy is nothing but the maximum energy for a temperature 0. So it is a very important quantity in the case of fermions, and Fermi energy can be written as in the case of we know that the EF equal to this one, so Fermi energy can be written also in the case of this, only in the terms of EF also. So basically if I write this in the term of EF, it is making us see, if I write this as EF equal to minus alpha kt, okay, so replace this by, replace the alpha by EF by kt, minus EF by kt. So if I replace the alpha minus EF by kt, so we are getting this equation, and for that the Fd value is half. For that this value to be is made to be half. Okay, why it is made to be half, let us discuss. See, when temperature equal to 0, the Fermi level energy is maximum. Okay, and we can say that in temperature equal to 0, this can be greater than this, because the energy level should be greater than the Fermi energy level, or the opposite can also happen. Okay, so what will be in the case of this? So if I consider this term greater, so this term is greater, okay, so it will come minus and it will come infinity. This is minus infinity, and e to the power minus infinity is 0, so it is coming as 1. And when t equal to 0, this term is greater, and as the t is 0, it will also come as infinity, because t is 0, when 0 will go to up, it will become infinity. But here this is greater, this one is greater, this e term is greater. So as this e term is greater, it is become infinity, not minus infinity, because e term is greater. So e to the power infinity, and 1 by e to the power infinity plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, how it is coming, let us see. Let multiply e to the power minus infinity on top and bottom. So if I multiply here, e to the power minus infinity is coming 0. Okay, and if I do this, this is coming 1, and it is also coming 0. So 0 by 1 is 0. Now let us see the next one. See here that why we are taking this as a half. We are considering that EF equals to E, that is the Fermi energy is equal, that is at the maximum point, is equal to that energy only that we are supplying. Okay, so FD of E equals to 1 by E minus EF by KT plus 1, and if this is equal, so it will become 0 whole term, and it will become to half. Okay, and this is for a maximum energy. Now at t equal to 0, it will become half. Okay, and at 2 equal to 0, at t equal to finite, it will become half. So if I look at this diagram, see t equal to 1 by 0 EF by K. Okay, that means that it will always become greater than 1. Okay, now see, if it is becoming greater than 1, it will be always be half. Okay, at the perfect t equal to 0, it will become, so the graph like this, but at the t greater than equal to 0 but less than equals to 1, the graph will show like this. Okay, at t equal to greater than 1, it will show like this. At t equal to 0, it will, graph will show like this. And at the t greater than equal to 0 but less than equal to 1, the graph will show like this. So this is the Fermi Dirac statistics, and